Bonjour! Hi! Welcome to another episode of Cloud in 5 Minutes. I'm Frank Boucher, and today I want to show you a quick tip to make your deployment work every time. Aussi, si vous préférez, j'ai une version en français de cette vidéo. Cliquez juste ici, en haut à droite. So your code is ready, is done, and now you want to deploy it in Azure to see if everything is working. So you took your script in PowerShell or Azure CLI and you're running it. Let's see this one. Oh no, it happened again. That name is already taken. Okay, you could just add a digit like 01, 02, 03 until you find the one that nobody took. Well, it's not very nice. You could also use a variable, something random, and add it at the end of the name. But the problem with this solution is every time it will be a new string. So if you want to redeploy this web app, then you're screwed because the name will have changed. Your solution is to use an ARM template for Azure Resource Manager. Let me show you. An ARM template is just a JSON file that describes the structure. So here I have an ARM template that describes exactly the same structure that would have been created by the Azure CLI script. Of course, if I run this ARM template, I will have the same error because my app is running that demo app name. So in ARM template, you have many different functions because it's not a JSON file, it's like a JSON file. You have multiple resources at your disposal. Let me show you. So for example, the one we want to use right now will create a suffix and add it to the end of our name. So let's create a function, another function, a variable. So if I want a value of suffix to be processed in the ARM template, I need to put it between square brackets. So just like that. And I want to use today Unix string. And if we look at the definition, Unix string will take a few parameters and create a unique string. Great. So what we will be using is the resource group ID, because we're always deploying in a resource ID and that should be unique to our case. To be even more sure, if we're deploying our solution in multiple data center, different location, we could add location also. So just add here the resource group and then location. Whoop. Yep. Resource group dot location. Voila. And now I have a suffix that will be unique. I just need to add it to my name. If I'm using it right now, for example, if I'm creating a storage, I may encounter some problem because storage required only lowercase. So you know what? Let's put a lowercase. So to do that, you just need to add toLower, and toLower will take a string and put it in lowercase. Very simple, right? Excellent. Now I have a very long Unix string. Maybe I would like to have something shorter. I don't want like a big blob of letters. I want just like a little suffix, maybe 5 character, maybe 10 character. It depends on you. For this demo, I will take 5. So let's do a substring. If I can spell it correctly. So substring, and substring will take the string to parse, index to where it start, and the length. Perfect. So we'll go here and then we'll start from the beginning, 0, and we'll take 5 character long. Great. So now I have a 5 character long lowercase string that will be unique for this deployment. Excellent. I just need to use it. So to use it, we'll go back in our app name variable and we'll just put everything between square brackets, just like this. And we'll use the function name concat. So concat. Concat, if we're looking at the definition, will take a few string and just put everything together. Excellent. So first we want a string demo app, and then the second string will be our suffix that is available in variables. So just like that, I want to use suffix, and I'm closing my concat. Great. So now everything works. So let's try it. So first we save. Excellent. And we go back to my script. So now to create, to use an ARM template is very easy. You just say az group, and then you will say deployment. We'll say create, and we'll give it a name. So let's say the name will be used to retrieve your logs in the portal. So let's just test, and then I will use the same resource group that I had previously. And of course, I will need to pass the file. So what did I did wrong? Deployment. Oh, I have a typo here. And I need the template file. And in my case, the template file was in local folder and it was called Azure deploy.json. So like this, Azure deploy.json. And just like that, if I execute this, I should have my solution. Excellent. It passed, obviously. So now let's go in the portal, check what we have. So now we have it demo with the RBMDO, that is our unique string that has been generated. The beauty of using an ARM template is by default, if let's say I want to add a storage, then I add it to my ARM template, and if I redeploy it, nothing will happen to my website since it already exists. Just the storage will be added. With this quick tip, your deployment should work every time. Also, if you want to know more about the ARM template, have a look to that video. Also, I will put in the description a few links about ARM template. Thank you for watching. Bye.